Hello everyone, my name is Sanya Chhabra and I have secured All India Rank 84 in UPSC Civil Services Examination 2018 and it was my first attempt. And today I'll be discussing with you the art of note making that I followed. So note making is one of the most essential parts as far as UPSC Civil Services Examination preparation is concerned. The key lies in how effective notes you make. So first of all, there is a choice between offline and online note making. I made offline notes, but it is always recommended to make online notes because it is easier to add, delete, or you know, edit a few things in the online note making process. What I did was I maintained separate notebooks for all the GS papers, be it GS 1, 2, 3, 4, optional for essay and for prelims if you have to note down certain facts. As far as the separate notebooks were concerned, you can add all the current affairs material that you're reading either from the newspaper or from monthly magazine or Yojana in the given subheading that is mentioned in the syllabus. Now, your entire notebook has to be filled with all the topics that are mentioned in the syllabus. For instance, in paper 1 of GS, there is history, geography, society, art and culture. So these are the broad topics that you need to write in that one notebook. Or maybe you can form separate notebooks for GS1 part-wise. And then in all these subject-wise notes, you have to write static notes. If you have joined any coaching center, then they'll be providing you with these notes. And in all those static notes, have some space left. If you're making online, then there's no such requirement. Add all those notes under the subheading that is given in the syllabus. So your notes should be bifurcated subject-wise. You should not write all the notes in one notebook. At least that is something that I would suggest, so that it becomes easier for you to segregate your notes one, and when you revise them, they will be imprinted in your mind topic-wise, and that will make it easier for you to, you know, replicate it in the mains examination or maybe prelims examination. So separate notebooks, syllabus-wise subheadings, addition of static as well as current parts under those subheadings itself. Then I also maintained a separate notebook for government schemes, which help you, you know, add to the answers, especially in the conclusion. When there's a certain question on, say, problems of a particular area, or what suggestions would you give to solve this area, then schemes come handy. When you write government schemes, it helps you end the answer on a positive and an optimistic note. So that helps you in enriching the answer by providing government schemes. So that was all about note making strategy. It should be very well streamlined and planned. Do not mess things up by, you know, maintaining just one notebook and adding all the notes there in one notebook. I believe that it is important to maintain separate notebooks for all papers and then note down the current affairs or static part subject wise under the given headings in the syllabus. That's all. All the very best and thank you.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.